Hey there, my friend. Welcome back to Simple Happy Zen. It's Vera, and today I have 30 tips for you to help simplify your life. These are all things that I like to do, and they can be very effective. If you ask me, life is too short to make it complicated, so let's make it easier. This video is part two, where I share the second half of my 30 tips to simplify your life. If you've missed part one, I will link it here and in the description, of course, so you can check it out after this one. Let's begin. The first tip is something that you can start doing today and will immediately have a huge impact, and that is to simplify your mornings. And there are a lot of things we can do to create a more relaxed morning routine for ourselves. You can lay out your outfit the night before so you know exactly what you're going to wear. You can already pack your bag the night before. I also like to make my breakfast the night before, so something like overnight oats or chia pudding, and you can even make your lunch as well. This way you can enjoy your relaxed mornings, take time to enjoy your breakfast, and make everything so much simpler. Most adults need around 7 to 9 hours of sleep a night, and the best thing you can do to be energized during the day is to have a sleep schedule. And this means going to bed around the same time each night and waking up around the same time each morning, even on weekends. Of course, there can be days where you have to change it up a little, and that's okay. But if we don't have some regularity, then it can be really hard on our body and our mind. So bringing some regularity to our sleep schedule will make it easier for us to be energized during the day and get things done. A lot of people who start their simplifying journey, they start by simplifying and decluttering their home. We've talked about this in part one, and I think that's a great place to start. But if we keep bringing new things into our home, it's not really going to make things any simpler. So by becoming a conscious consumer, we start to really think through every purchase that we make, and we are very mindful of bringing in things that add value. I talk about this more in my minimalism and money saving video. You can find it right here. Oh my gosh, those few weeks in my 20s when I counted my calories were so complicated. If you ask me, food is to be enjoyed and not calculated. It can make us feel guilty about any calories we consume. So if you just try your best to eat healthy and only enjoy a snack here and there, if you ask me, there's no real need to count our calories or go on any rigorous diets. If you let that go, life instantly gets simpler. Simplifying life is for a large part about making things less complicated and limiting distractions. And for most people, their phone is their biggest distraction in life. On average, we spend hours a day on our phone. Imagine if we could cut that time down by even half, how much time we would get to spend on other things. I talk more about getting a healthy relationship with your phone in this video right here, if you want more info. Complications tend to creep into our life in small ways, and figuring out what to make for dinner can be one of such ways. Some days I just don't really know what I want to make, I have no inspiration. And what really helps me then is to have a few go-to options for each meal of the day, so for breakfast, lunch, and dinner. These are things that I always enjoy, so whenever I don't really know what to make, I just do one of my go-to meals. Same with figuring out what to wear. Sometimes we just don't know, and we spend so much time and energy figuring out what to wear and changing our shirt 4 times before going out. For those kind of days, it really helps to have a few go-to outfits that you always know that you feel confident in. And of course, minimalism and decluttering your closet are great ways to help you choose those go-to outfits. Number 8, stop using your car for short distances, if it's possible, of course. If you only have to go a few blocks, it's so nice to just grab your bike or simply walk there. Getting out in the fresh air, getting your body moving is such a great way to clear your head and simplify your day. You also don't have to worry about parking. We live in a time where most things can be done digitally, and sometimes we forget that we are people who are programmed to enjoy being around other people. So I find that scheduling time to be around other people instead of just messaging each other, for example, can really work wonders. And if you are hanging out with people, leave your phone in your bag, don't take it out, just enjoy this quality time and truly connect with someone. Number 10, when my workspace is clean and tidy, I find it so much easier to be productive and focus on my tasks. And since we don't have a separate office in this apartment, my workspace is my living room. So taking 5 or 10 minutes before starting your work to tidy up and organize has a big impact on the rest of the day. Clutter is distracting and it fills up my mind with noise, so having a clean workspace really helps to simplify my workday. I find that cats are such an inspiration for simple living because when we look at them, they are often being very mindful and just enjoying life. When they just lie there basking in the sunlight, I get reminded that this is what life is about, enjoying each moment and appreciating the small things in life. Life is not just about to-dos, and it can be very easy for me to forget that. So go and be like a cat a few times a day, go stand near your window, feel the sunlight on your skin, and just enjoy. Goal setting can be great, but it is easy to make too many and feel overwhelmed by all your goals. So my suggestion is to only have a few, preferably one for each area in your life. This way you can keep growing and learning without burning the candle at both ends and feeling burnt out. Something I've been working on recently is establishing routines or workflows for the recurring tasks in my life, and making videos for this channel is a great example. Instead of working crazy hard on things without a plan, I've now implemented time blocks into my day where I just work on scripting or I just work on editing, and I have these routines that work well and that are logical, and I find that this is super helpful in getting things done in a relaxed and efficient way. Take a deep breath in and a deep breath out. Relax your shoulders down and voila, instant simplification. Trust me, this really works. Number 15, see if you can try to stop trying to impress people. And let me explain what I mean by this, because I see this in a lot of people and I also see it in myself sometimes. We tend to think for others and we want to optimize their opinion of us. We want people to see us in the best light. So we spend a lot of energy trying to hide our flaws, be it personal or physical flaws, because we don't want people to see them. When we let go of this, you won't believe the freedom this brings, and I am only recently starting to truly see all the benefits that come with this because it was such a challenge for me, but it has made my life so much easier and simpler, not having to think about impressing people and how they see me. I am just me and that's what it is. And it's incredibly freeing and I would recommend this to everyone. Let me know your favorite simplifying tips in the comments. Give the video a like if you enjoyed it. Consider subscribing and check out my Simplify Your Life playlist for more inspiration. I will see you soon. Bye bye.